हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज़ आशा खिलरानी। आई विल टीच यू डेटा स्ट्रक्चर सब्जेक्ट। वी विल सी द कंप्लीट टीचिंग प्लान ऑफ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर सब्जेक्ट इन दिस वीडियो।
आई डिवाइडेड डेटा स्ट्रक्चर सब्जेक्ट इनटू 9 पार्ट्स। इन फर्स्ट पार्ट आई विल टीच यू इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर्स। इन सेकेंड पार्ट आई विल टीच यू एरे। इन थर्ड पार्ट लिंक लिस्ट। इन फोर्थ पार्ट स्टैक। इन फिफ्थ पार्ट क्यू। इन सिक्स्थ पार्ट सर्चिंग। In seventh part sorting, eighth part is tree, and part 9 is graph. By knowing all these topics, you will completely know what is data structure subject and what is the importance of this subject. In part 1, which is the introduction of data structure, we will study in first video basic terms which are algorithm, data, program, software, importance of data structure, definitions of data structures. And second video we will learn what are the classification of data structures, primitive and non-primitive data structures, linear and non-linear data structure. In third video we will study data structure operations that are create, delete, traversal, searching, insertion, deletion, sorting and merging. These three videos cover the introduction part of data structure. In part 2 we will learn array, which is the example of linear data structure. In first video we will learn what is array, why we use array, declaration and initialization of array, types of arrays, properties of array. In second video we will learn advantages and disadvantages of array. The advantage of array is easy creation and access of similar type elements, and disadvantages, insertion and deletion operation is time consuming, and size of array should be known in advance. It requires contiguous memory allocation. In third video we will study two-dimensional array, which is also called as matrix, and we will also study multidimensional array. In this video we will learn memory allocation of two-dimensional array, which is row measure and column measure order. In fourth video we will learn address calculation of one-dimensional array, which contains formula and one example. In fifth video we will learn address calculation in two-dimensional array with formula for row measure order and column measure order and one example. In sixth video we will also learn address calculation in two-dimensional array with some other examples. In part 3 we will learn linked list, which is also an example of linear data structure. In first video we will learn how the linked list overcomes the drawbacks of array. In this video we will cover definition, advantages and disadvantages of linked list. In second video we will learn types of linked list. There are three types of linked list. First is singly linked list, having single pointer to store address of next node, that's why it is called as singly linked list. In doubly linked list, it have double or two pointers to store address of previous and next node, hence it is called as doubly linked list. And third is circular linked list, in which pointer of last node store address of first node to make list circular, hence it is called as circular linked list. In third video I will tell you the difference between array and linked list. Array is a collection of similar type elements, while linked list is a collection of similar type nodes. In array there is contiguous memory allocation, while in linked list there is non-contiguous memory allocation. In array the size of array should be known in advance, but in linked list size of linked list should not be known in advance. Insertion and deletion is time consuming in array, while insertion and deletions are easier in linked list. In fourth video we will learn insertion in singly linked list at first position. First I will tell you the logic and then I will explain the algorithm. Similarly, insertion at last position will be covered in fifth video, and insertion at specified position covered in sixth video. Similarly, in seventh video I will tell you the deletion in singly linked list at first position with logic and algorithm, and in eighth video we will learn deletion at last position, and in ninth video we will learn deletion at a specified position. That means insertion and deletion in linked list can be performed at first position, at last position or at a specified position. In tenth video I will cover insertion in doubly linked list at first position with logic and algorithm, and in 11th video insertion in doubly linked list at last position, and in 12th video insertion in doubly linked list at specified location. Similarly, in video 13, 14, 15, we will learn deletion in doubly linked list at first position, at last position, and at specified position. In 16, 17, and 18th video, we will learn insertion in circular singly linked list at first position, at last position, at a specified position with logic and algorithm. In 19, 20, and 21 video, we will learn in deletion in circular singly linked list at first position, at last position, and at specified position with logic and algorithm. And in 22nd video, we will learn applications of linked list, in which we will cover polynomial manipulation like addition of two polynomials using linked list. In fourth part, we will study stack, which is also a linear data structure. In first video, we will learn concept of stack. In second, push algorithm using array. And in third video, we will learn pop algorithm using array. That means in a stack, we can perform two operations, push and pop. Push is for insertion and pop is for deletion operation. Similarly, push and pop algorithm can be implemented using linked list, which we will study in fourth and fifth video. Next is applications of stack. We will see what are the different applications of stack in 6th video. In 7th and 8th video, I will tell you the conversion of infix to postfix expression using some examples. In 9th video, I will tell you the algorithm for that. In 10th video, we will learn evaluation of postfix expression using stack. In 11th and 12th video, I will teach you how to convert infix to prefix expression using a stack, and in 13th video I will tell you algorithm for infix to prefix conversion using a stack. Next we will see recursion, which is the application of stack with example. What are the basic requirements and advantages and disadvantages of recursion, Tower of Hanoi problem, and multiple stack in 14, 15, 16, 17th video. In fifth part of this subject, I will teach you queue, which is a linear data structure. In first video, I will teach you concept of queue. In second and third, I will teach you insert and delete algorithm using array. In fourth and fifth video, I will teach you insert and delete algorithm using linked list. In sixth video, I will teach you limitations of simple queue.
We can overcome limitations of simple queue using circular queue.
In 7th and 8th video, I will teach you insertion and deletion algorithm of circular queue. In 9th video, I will teach you double-ended queue, that is DQ. And in 10th video, I will teach you priority queue. Then we will see applications of queue in 11th video. In part 6th of data structure subject, I will teach you what is searching. There are two types of searching, linear search and binary search. In first and second video, I will teach you what is linear search with example, how linear search work with example, and its algorithm with its time complexity. And in third and fourth video, I will teach you binary search with example, its algorithm, and its time complexity. In part 7th, I will teach you sorting. In first video, I will teach you selection sort with its concept, example, algorithm, and its time complexity. Here we will see only the formula for time complexity in best case, worst case, and average case. But in detail,
we will study in analysis and design of algorithm subject.
Early in second video, I will teach you insertion sort. In 5th, 6th, and 7th, we will learn quick sort, merge sort, and heap sort. In 8th part, we will learn tree, which is an example of nonlinear data structure. In tree, we will learn terminology of tree data structure, types of trees, array, and linked list representation of tree in 1st, 2nd, and 3rd video. Then we will learn binary search tree, with its definition, insertion and deletion in binary search tree with example and algorithm. Then we will learn tree traversal techniques. There are three tree traversal techniques: in order, post order and pre order. We will see in these traversal techniques with example. Then we will see the algorithm of these techniques. Then I will tell you a numerical on construction of binary tree using in order and post order traversal and using in order and pre order traversal. Then we will see threaded binary tree. Then we will study what is AVL or height balance tree, then types of rotations which are required in AVL tree, that are LL, RR, LR and RL rotations. Then we will see insertion in AVL tree with examples. Then we will see heap tree, what is heap, what are the types of heaps, construction of max heap and construction of min heap with example. Forest and general tree, what is the forest and general tree, how we convert general tree to binary tree. Then we will see the various applications of tree: Huffman fixed length encoding technique, Huffman variable length encoding technique. Then we will learn M-way search tree, its properties, B-tree, which is also an example of M-way search tree, insertion and deletion in B-tree, B plus tree. Then we will learn red black tree, its properties, insertion in red black tree, example of construction of red black tree. And in ninth part we will learn graph, which is also an example of nonlinear data structure. In graph we will study its definition, types of graphs, difference between tree and graph, representation techniques of graph. Then we will learn what is spanning tree, what is minimum spanning tree. Then there are two algorithms which are used to calculate minimum cost spanning tree, which are Kruskal algorithm and Prim's algorithm, which we will study with example and algorithm. Next we will learn graph traversal techniques. There are two graph traversal techniques: depth first search and breadth first search traversal technique. And we will learn DFS and BFS with example and its algorithm. Next we will learn application of graph. We will see various application of graph. We will study example and algorithm of Dijkstra's to calculate shortest path from source node to all other remaining nodes of the graph.
So these are the topics which I will teach you in data structure subject.